Is Manus the AI tool to 100x your productivity? You'll find out in this video as I show you how to automate complex tasks using Manus AI. To get started with automating complex tasks, we are going to visit manus.im. Once you visit the webpage, you will see something like what's on the screen right now. And before we actually try to automate something ourselves, we're going to take a look at some of the better examples. If we go ahead to data analysis, which I think Manus excels at really well, and view this particular space, I think a great use case is creating these micro tools or these small tools around, in this case, children's education cost planner. Or if we take a look at another one, we can see the S&P 500 best performers analysis. So visualizing data, analyzing data, and putting it into a very attractive format, sometimes with interactive calculators. I think Manus does that incredibly well. If we visit research, some of the research capabilities are particularly interesting. So we're going to take a look at the tab, and you can see here we have apartment comparison. So we take a look at this particular one. What we can see is Manus has gone out and compared different apartments in different neighborhoods. This potentially might be the New York area, potentially. And it's comparing the price, bedrooms. So it's doing a lot of research for you. Another great use case for Manus. Lastly, if we head over to IT and development, there's another one that I find particularly interesting. So let's take a look at this space. And it's an architecture skills matrix. So it's putting into a matrix the skills that you will need for specific technology roles. Again, super, super interesting. Another way to gather information from the internet, create a small tool around it that could be great for your personal use, great for your company internally, or just great for people in general if you want to create useful tools that people might like, maybe to drive traffic to your website or for another reason. The first thing we're going to try is to create a use case matrix for large language models in different departments of a real estate agency. And what we want to see is Manus's ability to go out, research a topic, and formalize and synthesize that information and put it in a matrix that's really easy and digestible that for the end user. So we give it our prompt and press enter. Interestingly enough, an internal server error has occurred and it couldn't complete the task. So it said it did complete the initial research, but it failed somewhere along the line. It says it will refund me the full credits. And so I'm not quite sure whether to terminate the task and refund credits or try again. I do want to try this again. So what I'm going to do is just copy my initial prompt. I'm going to terminate the task and refund credits. And then I'm going to create a new task. So we've tried this again, and it seems like another internal server error has occurred. So again, we're going to terminate this task and refund credits, and we're going to try to give it a different task. This time, what we're going to do is to try to create an interactive calculator for analyzing the return on investment of spend on artificial intelligence in a company. So we're going to keep it broad and to see what it comes up with. It seems like Manus has now completed the task of creating an interactive ROI calculator for AI marketing spend. And it's asking me, do I want to deploy the website publicly? And let's just say yes. And while it's deploying, we'll take a look at the history. Initially, it started by doing research. And then it made a plan on what to do and how to build it. And obviously, building an interactive tool requires coding. So you can see it's using different tools or tool use to be able to complete different tasks. It was editing files. It ran into errors. So it was actually fixing errors that it ran into that ironically it created. I believe it's now finished and it has a link for me. And maybe if we click on this, we might be able to see. So this is what the UI looks like, but this isn't the public link to use it. Okay, here we have the public link, and I'm just going to click on this. And we have our AI ROI calculator for marketing agencies. And let's just say the initial investment is 10,000, the monthly cost is 1,000, and the user has to put the input parameters. And let's just leave it as it is, and we're going to hit calculate ROI. Okay, it creates a monthly projection. That is great. It creates an ROI visualization, which is also great. It gives several different visualization views, which is amazing. We can export this as a PDF. So let's just see if this works. Okay, it hasn't implemented this export as a PDF functionality. And if we hit calculate again, we'll show sensitivity analysis. Okay, it hasn't implemented this functionality either, I don't believe. So it's got 90 or 80% of the way. So this does look great. In reality, this would be slightly problematic though. So a user or an agency, they would know how much their initial investment is. They might not even know how much their monthly AI costs would be. They might have an idea of the time period for the ROI. They won't know the revenue impact. They might know the desired revenue impact is maybe what they should put here. They won't know the cost savings, or maybe they will put their target cost savings, and they will know their agency metrics. So there would have to be a little bit more information to help the user along on how to use this particular calculator. Let's try creating one more tool using Manus. With this next task, we are going to create a comparison tool. And I've just chosen a random idea for a comparison tool. Here in the UK, people are vaping a lot. And potentially a comparison tool that people would use would be to choose what kind of vape they might prefer. So we have our prompt, create an interactive comparison tool for types of e-liquid flavors and nicotine strengths. And we're going to click enter. In this particular example, it is prompting me to give it information about what specific features would like on the comparison tool, what types of e-liquid and what flavors. So from question two to five, or maybe two to four or five, I'm going to tell it, hey, just do your thing. We've run into another system error. So this time, instead of terminating the task, I'm going to ask it to try again. Manus is almost ready and it wants to deploy the application. So I'm going to allow it to deploy the application. Now Manus is ready. Let's take a look at our comparison tool. We are going to visit the URL and we have different filters. We have e-liquid type, nicotine strength. We can sort it by name and price. And it has researched a list of different e-liquids. So if we click that, we can actually see, I guess, information about different types of e-liquids. We can see information about nicotine strengths. Okay, let's filter Freebase. And let's hit add to comparison and add to comparison here. So we have a list on the first page. And you can see compare to here. We'll go to compare to. What we have here is super interesting. It has a list initially. So you select the items you want from the list to compare. You go to compare and it starts to compare the items in the list by price, description, flavors, nicotine strength, who it's best for, and even has some educational information about understanding the differences. If you're a consultant, student, or even a researcher, I think Manus is an amazing way to create interactive tools, interactive charts, animations from heaps of data that you're trying to analyze. Manus is definitely one to watch in a suite of AI tools that automate complex tasks, and I'm looking forward to seeing how they develop the platform. Thanks for watching. Be sure to check out the link in the description to go to No Code MBA. a learning platform with dozens of in-depth, high-quality courses on no-code and AI taught by industry experts. And be sure to subscribe to our channel here to get more free content on YouTube. Thanks again, and we'll see you in the next video.